Hello friends, in this video I will help you understand what is Prony Brake Dynamometer with its construction and how it works. Also I will give you all the formula of power which we can calculate by using Prony Brake Dynamometer. So here I am having the diagram of a Prony Brake Dynamometer. It consists of a pulley which is attached to this shaft. As we can see here at the center we are having a shaft. This shaft is the shaft whose power is what we want to measure. We want to measure the power of this shaft. So for that we are mounting a brake drum, or you can say pulley, over this shaft. Next, here we are having wooden blocks which are mounted just above the pulley. Nuts and bolts arrangement are also provided so that we can adjust the gap between the wooden blocks and the drum here. Next, we are having a lever. As we can see, from the center of the shaft to the point at which we are applying the load, this W indicates the load which we apply. So from the center of shaft to the load, here we call it as L, which is the length of the lever considered. Stoppers are provided to stop or restrict the motion of the lever from going to extreme condition. That is, lever should not move in extreme downward or upward direction. Then we are having counterweight to avoid the vibrations of the lever. So this was regarding the construction. Now how it functions? See, Prony Brake Dynamometer is a type of absorption dynamometer because it stops the shaft and then measures the power. So here I can say that Prony Brake Dynamometers, they are of absorption type. So how it functions? At first the shaft is rotating. We have mounted the brake drum, so this brake drum or pulley will also rotate. Here it is given anti-clock, so it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. We will be attaching weights here. Once we attach weight here, the lever would be moving in the downward direction. Along with that, the clamp, the wooden clamps or wooden blocks, they would be moving down. This upper block would be moving down. So the moment we are attaching, we are going on increasing the value of load here. The wooden blocks, they come closer to the brake drum, and once the load value has reached up to a value where it will be just coming in contact with the brake drum stops. And when the brake drum stops, at that time we will be noting the value of W, how much is the load here and what is the length of this lever. So power is calculated, it is given by the formula 2 pi n by 60 into W into L for row brake dynamometer, where W is the load which we are attaching at the end of the lever and L is the length of the lever. So in this way we would be measuring power by Prony Brake Dynamometer.